everyone, welcome back to our channel, and I know you are very excited about this giveaway because I've been mentioning this through my previous videos, and now here they are. So if you want to join this giveaway, just keep on watching. So anyway, this video giveaway is sponsored by Pigeon Baby, one of our favorite brands ever since I got Yale. So that's more than 8 years now, and ever since I got Yale, we've been using that brand, and we really love it, from their liquid cleansers to their storage bottles and so on and so forth. So here is the giveaway that you've been waiting for, and for the first prize, so I'm giving away two sets of prizes for this giveaway. So for the first prize, this is actually a Pigeon breast pump. Okay, it's a manual breast pump, and this costs like around 4,000 or 5,000 in the market or at SM Baby Company. So this is a very nice pump. I personally have this, I'm sponsored by Pigeon as well, and I do love this pump because it doesn't actually hurt my breasts. And of course, this is a very, very nice brand, Pigeon. If you haven't known yet, Pigeon is a brand from Japan. So, you know, if we say Japan, they do have the quality products from cars, etc. So anyway, this is the first prize, Pigeon breast pump, manual breast pump, plus some disposable breast pads. The Honeycomb breast pads from Pigeon is very nice as well. I've been using this when I was breastfeeding Orion, and this is very nice. So it doesn't give you any leaks, and it gives you a lot of protection, especially if your breasts are leaking, you know, when you were just starting to breastfeed, yung kasagsagan ng milk. It's a very, very nice and easy to wear under your nursing bra. So this comes together with this, but I'm giving away lots of this, not just two pieces. And of course, for the second prize, we're giving away a Pigeon liquid cleanser. It's 650 ml refill pack, and as you can see, there are fruits and vegetables on the packaging. That means it's very safe to use for your baby's things, feeding stuff, and you can also use them to wash fruits and vegetables to make sure that they are always clean before you give them to your babies. And also a pack, a 36 pieces pack of Pigeon Honeycomb breast pads. So this, as what I mentioned, this is very great. And this is very nice for you breastfeeding moms out there. Just keep on watching this video because I'm going to tell you a little bit of our breastfeeding journey with Orion. So just keep on watching. So there, I mentioned that I'm going to tell you a little bit of a story about our breastfeeding journey, because, you know, I'm not a breastfeeding expert. Whatever I share with you guys or with those moms that I have talked to before, whatever I'm sharing is about all my experiences as a breastfeeding mom, because I wasn't given the chance yet to, you know, attend seminars or certifications to be a breastfeeding counselor or whatever you call it. So anyway, all of my experiences are based on research, my personal experience, of course, plus all of the learnings that I have about breastfeeding are based from researches, from the workshops that I attended, from the seminars that I attended, and for my personal experience. And of course, I am also asking some of our lactation counselors that I know, because here in Pampanga, I know some lactation counselors. Actually, I only know one lactation counselor here in Pampanga, and that is Mommy Laarni. Hi, Mommy Laarni. I know you've been very helpful. She's been very helpful, especially to our group, Pampanga Circle of Moms. So thank you so much for helping out every time we have some questions about breastfeeding. All right. So anyway, here's a little story about our breastfeeding journey. So totoo na to, ito na yung story talaga. So I had my firstborn, Kuya Yale, last May of 2011. At that time, I wasn't really that sure about breastfeeding. I don't know enough about breastfeeding. So I know there are social media groups that time already, but I wasn't that really, you know, hardworking enough to research, to do my research, or to ask for breastfeeding tips and tricks or whatever, or advices. And when I gave birth to him, he was actually induced. So when I gave birth to Kuya, I was informed by, you know, people surrounding me, or by, okay, anyway, by the hospital, I'm gonna, you know. So they informed me that I have to bring baby bottles, water for my kid. So of course, because I'm a first-time mom, I was a first-time mom by that time, and nobody's like telling me, okay, you have to breastfeed as soon as the baby comes out, or whatever, whatever it is. So I brought baby bottles. So that was 8 years ago, or more than 8 years ago, because he's 8 years old now. So I brought baby bottles, and when I was asleep after giving birth, so my husband didn't know what to do because the baby's crying. So the nurse, she's a very old nurse, not really very old, but she's an old nurse at that time, and they gave him formula milk, and I didn't know about that. So when I woke up, I just learned that they are feeding him, you know, formula. And so that was my first concern. And then when we went home, my parents told me that you have to breastfeed your child, because if not, so mapupuno daw yung breast and lalagnatin daw ako. So yun yung sinabi sa akin. So I tried my best. I actually, you know, this is not really a good thing, but I actually pumped some milk, because I was just like 3 days pa lang si Kuya Yale. And my sister-in-law lent me her breast pump, and I used it, and I feel na parang nabugbog yung breasts ko at that time. So I just tried, so there's no harm in trying, because I don't know everything about breastfeeding. And then eventually, Kuya Yale didn't want to, you know, breastfeed from me. I tried my best, but I guess my best wasn't good enough. So anyway, so that was a little bit of our breastfeeding journey with Kuya Yale. So I didn't have any, you know, any access, or I didn't have enough support to breastfeed him at that time. So I failed as a mom to breastfeed him. I know I shouldn't have blamed myself, but it looks like I'm the only one to blame, because I didn't get enough support, I didn't look for enough answers, or I didn't research for enough details or enough information so I can breastfeed him. So fast forward, since, you know, he was formula fed. So fast forward, after 5 years, as soon as I learned that I am pregnant with another baby, the first thing that popped into my mind actually is not about the gender of the baby. The first thing is I'm going to breastfeed my kid, and I'm going to do that exclusively, so without the help of formula milk, without anything. So I did all the researches. I actually joined a breastfeeding group on Facebook, that's Breastfeeding Pinay. So I joined, I asked breastfeeding advocates about this, and again, I asked Mommy Laarni again. Actually, I got to know her only after I gave birth to Orion. So, but that, at that very moment that I learned that I am going to be a mom again, that I'm going to have another child, I am fully decided that I'm going to breastfeed my child. No matter what happens, I'm going to exclusively breastfeed him until he weans. So, and now I'm doing this video because he finally weaned. So he's actually 2 years and 8 months now. He's turning 2 years and 8 months on June 7th. So yeah, and he finally weaned from breastfeeding. Actually, with all the researches that I did before I got, before I gave birth to Orion, so I add, my cousin actually bought me a an electric breast pump, which I didn't use before, you know, a couple of weeks, because I was afraid to, you know, to have mastitis or anything related to, you know, breastfeeding. Because of those research that I did, and I exclusively breastfed Orion, so I didn't bring any baby bottles. I actually didn't buy any baby bottles when I was pregnant. I am obsessed in, you know, storing milk storage bags, storage bottles, and I prepared for those storage things for breastfeeding, and breast pads, of course. That those are actually all of the things that I just prepared, and I did not bring any bottle inside the hospital when I gave birth. So I strictly told my husband that whatever happens, if the baby cries, bring it to me and I'm gonna breastfeed him. So that's really what happened. And some moms actually are very worried that when they gave birth, you know, that whenever I see moms post on Facebook, or whenever they ask me what they have to do, if they have to pump, because oh my god, ako hindi na lumalabas na milk, it's just that whenever I pump, ganyan. So hello, kakapanganak lang, you don't have to pump unless your doctor told you to do so, because of some situations, unavoidable situations that you and your baby are experiencing when you give birth. But again, pumping is not necessary when you give birth, because the baby will instantly suck on your nipples, on your breasts, to feed. It's natural. It's a natural thing for babies, so you don't have to worry about that. And another tip for moms who's giving birth, or who's gonna give birth soon, is don't stress out yourself. If you can't see any milk coming out of your breasts after you give birth, it's not a problem. You don't have to worry about it. Your baby's stomach is just as little as a calamansi. Calamansi? It's just, your baby's stomach is as little as a calamansi. So you don't have to worry about tons of milk, ounces of milk. Whatever your baby feeds directly from your breasts, it's just whatever your baby needs. It's just anything that your baby needs. And as he grows older, like for a few months, your milk will also increase. So whatever your breast is producing at the time you gave birth, that's just the amount of milk that your baby needs. You don't need 10 ounces of milk, 4 ounces of milk when you give birth. Anything that your baby sucks, or, you know, gets from your breasts, is just whatever he needs. It's not a problem if your baby is wanting to, you know, feed all the time. It's normal. I don't have to worry about that. All you have to do is, again, full support from your family. Tell your husband that you need his support. He needs to wash the dishes, he needs to feed your other kids, he needs to cook, whatever, for that 7 days of paternity leave, you know. Tell your husband, you need help. Get help from your other family members, like your mom, your sister-in-law, your brother-in-law, or whoever who can take care of the chores for you. Or get a nanny. Well, honestly, we don't have a nanny when I gave birth to Orion, so my husband was the one doing every chore at home, so there isn't any problem. I get to sleep all day because I'm breastfeeding Orion, so I sleep when he breastfeeds. So there. So that was just a little bit of our breastfeeding journey, and as I mentioned, we exclusively breastfed for two years and 8 months, no formula milk. And now he's actually more of, you know, playing stuff. I actually did enroll him to a play school during the summer, so he would know how to socialize with other kids. And it's perfect. It's great. and I can see that he's very active. He's a very active kid. Sometimes my mom and my relatives would actually say, "Oh my God, napaka-active niya. Ang likot niya." Yeah, he's malikot, but he's pretty sweet. So they definitely wanted to be with him all the time, even if so makulit. Even if so makulit, especially when we work always. So he's very makulit. And he'll just, you know, he'll just listen to his papa, not with me. Because of our bonding, I guess it's because of our bonding time, you know, because of the bonding that we had. So he just would like to listen to his papa and not with me. Yeah, and anyway, I think mahaba na tong video na nagawa ko. So here are the mechanics. I wasn't able to mention the mechanics earlier because I was so excited to tell you about our breastfeeding journey. So I wasn't able to tell you about the mechanics. So ayun na nga, if you wanted to win these Pigeon items, it's at the giveaway is open nationwide. Don't worry, because this is open nationwide. It's not just here in Pampanga. So everybody can join as long as you're residing in the Philippines. So all you have to do is, of course, subscribe on our channel, and you can also like this video. You can comment as well if you love this video, or if you have any questions about breastfeeding that I can answer, or I can ask for help if I don't know the answer, the exact answer. But of course, I can just you know, give you some other tips about breastfeeding. You can comment on this video, like, and of course don't forget to subscribe. And don't forget, because this is sponsored by Pigeon Baby, don't forget to follow their Instagram account. It's Pigeon Baby PH, I think. I'm gonna just put that on this description, or in this video, I'm just gonna put the Instagram account. And of course, my Instagram account, it's Mama Yen's Adventures. So follow me, follow Pigeon Baby account on Instagram. So, and of course, subscribe on my channel, on our channel. And the giveaway will be, again, open nationwide. And it will end on the 31st of July. So we have almost 2 months to, you know, you have almost 2 months. You can also share this video if you like. So if you have other friends who are currently pregnant, or who you know would love to win a breast pump from Pigeon, or these accessories, or these things from Pigeon, you can also tag them as well on whenever you share the video. Share as many times as you want. It doesn't matter, as long as you tag your friends, your soon-to-be mom friends, those who are, you know, giving birth soon, and those moms who needs a breast pump, anybody. Or you can also tag a father, a dad, to surprise his wife. Because I'm actually doing this video until the 31st of July to give away to the breastfeeding month, which will happen on August, and that's my birthday month. And on my birthday month, of course, we're giving away another set of prizes. And that's it. Don't forget, I'm gonna put on the instructions or the mechanics as well on this description box. And thank you so much for watching my video. I hope I got you inspired with our breastfeeding journey. And I'm gonna review the Pigeon breast pump that I have soon, and other breastfeeding stuff as well. And thank you. Have a great day.